Okay. Sorry, I'm a little parched. I'm just gonna drink some of my delicious coffee I have here. So good. All right, so guys, the moment everyone has been waiting for, and by everyone I mean the two of you guys that support and watch me and the only two that ever watch all my videos. This video is for you. The Q&A that I said I was gonna make. I'm gonna answer some of you guys' questions, and some of the questions that you guys can expect involve real estate, involve stocks, and even personal questions. For example, if I can go back 10 years and tell my younger self something, what would that be? Or another question that another friend asked, what is my biggest life lesson? All right, so first question, and actually before I get to this first question, I just wanna let you know that I'm gonna try to answer these questions as quickly as possible without going off too much on the tangent. So I'm just trying to be as direct and upfront as possible. So first question comes from my good friend Lance, and he asks, where did you learn about trading stocks and where would you recommend starting? So I actually learned about day trading stocks from a good friend, Ricky Gutierrez. And for those of you guys that don't know who he is, he's a young entrepreneur from Arizona. He makes a living day trading stocks. And so I took his course. I learned how to trade stocks through his course. And I would recommend first doing your research online, because there's different things that you can do with stocks. You can day trade them, which is what I do. You can swing trade them. You can long-term hold, invest in stocks. Go online, do your research, go on YouTube, read online articles and see what strategy would attract you most and what fits you the best. If you're a more riskier type, I would say day trade. If you are a more, you know, moderate type, swing trade. If you are very, very conservative, see if you can go for the long-term investing. So I would recommend by first going online, do some research and see what strategy, what method is most attractive to you. And once you figure it out, go online and see who does that style of trading that you're into. Like I said, I found Ricky Gutierrez, I bought his course, and I learned how to day trade stocks that way. Next question comes from my brother, and he asks, when are you gonna come home again and play some Call of Duty? Well, Paco, if you haven't noticed, we are in a pandemic. We're supposed to be practicing social distancing. So once all this is over, I guarantee you, I'm gonna go over and kick your ass. All right, next question comes from a gentleman named Tony, and he asks, what is your biggest complaint about my job? And for those of you guys that don't know what it is I do, I'm actually a real estate agent. I help people buy, sell, and invest in real estate. That's the majority of my job. And I have a lot of fun doing it. But my biggest complaint about this job are people who waste time. For example, I was working with a client a few months ago, and we were going back and forth looking at homes, spending a lot of my own time driving to these properties and viewing these properties and previewing these properties for this client, all to find out that he's not gonna buy, he doesn't wanna buy, and he was just looking around to see what the market was like. Complete waste of my time. So I hate people who are looky-loos, is what we call them. Don't waste time. And this just doesn't go with my job. I hate people who waste time in general and everything. If you're not serious about something, just don't waste people's time. All right, next question comes from Jackie Gordon, and she's actually a good friend of mine, long-term supporter of me and my YouTube channel, and thank you so much, Jackie. And she asks, what is my biggest life lesson? My biggest life lesson is to embrace mistakes. Don't look at mistakes as a bad thing. Look at it more in the fact that you can grow from them and learn from them. Without mistakes, people just don't grow. People just don't learn, and people just don't mature. I think mistakes are a good thing. Now, if you happen to make the mistake consecutively and multiple times, it is not a mistake at that point, it is a choice. So if you make a mistake, learn from it, see how you can do things differently, and grow from it. So mistakes, I think, are my biggest life lesson. Now, my friend Emmanuel, long-term childhood friend, Emmanuel, thank you for tuning in. He asked me two questions. His first question is, why real estate? What is your goal in a new career path? So all the people that I look up to, all the people who are successful in my eyes, they all have one thing in common, and that is real estate. Not in the sense that they help people buy and sell real estate like I do, but in the sense that they own real estate. So I got into real estate because I wanted to learn how to invest in real estate for myself so that I can own property sometime in the future. So that's why I got into real estate. And so to answer the second part of the question, what is a goal in real estate that I have? A goal is to be able to educate what I learned and what I've been learning and share it with you guys, because I think real estate is a really important way to to earn wealth and to grow your wealth. And so I want to be able to educate others from the things that I've learned. So that's a big goal of mine, and which is why I have this YouTube channel, or I'd like to share stuff on Instagram with you guys. Emmanuel's second question is, what interested you in law enforcement at first? So for those of you guys that do not know, I was actually in the running to become a police a few years ago, and I got disqualified for DUI. Anyway, so the reason I got into law enforcement, there is no reason. I just had nothing going for me at that point in life. I felt like I was wasting time doing nothing, so I decided to apply for the police academy. Luckily, I went through all the steps and I did it successfully until I got the DUI, obviously. But nothing really interested me about law enforcement. I just saw dollar signs. I saw that pension plan and I was like, fuck it, this is something that I need to get into. And looking back at it now, it's just, I'm glad that that didn't happen, because I was just going in it for the money and nothing else, which is not good. Next question comes from my good friend, Anna Paola Alonso. Good friend, great soccer player. I don't even know if you play anymore. Do you still play? She asked me, how did you get so lucky with friends like me? Actually, I should be asking you that question. How'd you get so lucky to be a friend of mine? Next question comes from Luxury Flights Only. That's her handle on Instagram, and they ask, do you travel business class often? And no, I don't. I wish I would travel business class often. That'd be awesome. If you can help me out with that, send me a DM. Next question comes from their Instagram handle is I am Wang C. And he asked, how old are you? I am 28. Actually, no, I take that back. I was born on February 29th, 1992, which is a leap year, leap day. So technically I am 7 years old. So that answers that question. And the other question he asked, do you have plans on posting a house tour of my listings? Yes, I'm actually creating a YouTube channel to be able to showcase all my listings on there, and that's in the works. So keep an eye out on that. All right, so next three questions come from my good friend, Joey Chavez. How are you, buddy? Hope your company and business is doing well. Anyway, so Joey asked, first question, as a kid, what did you want to be when you were all grown up besides a soccer player? He knew that my quick answer would be a soccer player. As a young kid growing up, I wanted to be a professional soccer player. Obviously, that didn't happen. So I didn't have any other plan, to be honest, growing up. It's just I wanted to be a soccer player. Not until like 4 years ago that I decided that I wanted to be in real estate, which is what I'm doing now, and I'm happier than ever. So next question that he asked, if you had to go back 10 years, what would you tell yourself knowing what you know now? I would say, don't waste your time. So 10 years ago, I'd be 18. I did a lot of partying and drinking, and just in that time of my life, just, my mind was just involved with the party scene. So if I can go back 10 years, I'd tell myself, it's okay to have some fun once in a while, but don't spend all your time doing that. Spend time doing something else. Learn how to trade stocks sooner. Learn how to invest in real estate sooner. Don't waste all your time just partying and thinking about when the next function would be. Just take some extra time to learn something new and learn something that's gonna actually provide value for yourself and for your future. So that's something I would tell myself, and not to be such a knucklehead. All right, last question that Joey asked was, if you had to prescribe anything to everyone in the world, what would that be? Jesus, I don't even know how to answer that question. It's so deep. Damn it, Joey. If I could prescribe one thing to the world, I think it would have to be empathy. I feel like a lot of people lack empathy in this world. They forget to put themselves in people's shoes sometimes, and a lot of people get judged. And I think before you should judge somebody, you should first try to understand the situation where they come from before judging them. I think the world would be a much happier place if, instead of judging, we would first learn about them and the situation, put ourselves in their shoes. And if we don't agree with them, fine, we don't agree with them. But I think we have to understand the situation before we say, what the fuck's wrong with you, you know? So I think empathy is something that I would like to prescribe to the entire world. All right, next question comes from a good friend. His name is Moreno. His Instagram handle is reject with two T's. And he asks, what are your current views on the treatment of the government on its citizen? And I think that's a broad question. It's really hard for me to answer, but I think he's alluding to what's going on now. And I think they're doing an all right job with closing down restaurants, shutting down events and sporting events. And that's helping to flatten the coronavirus spread, the curve of the coronavirus spread. So I think they're doing an okay job. And I think they're gonna start to tighten down on that in the upcoming weeks. So yeah, hopefully that answers your question. So next questions One, two, three, four, five, six, seven questions come from my friend Emily Jennings. How are you, Emily? Hope you're doing well with the family. First question she asked was, what is my go-to healthy snack? And I'm gonna put a screenshot of my go-to healthy snack right here. Think bars, chocolate brownie, or the lemon one. Oh, those are the best. They are healthy, low in calories, high in protein, low in sugars. It's just a delicious snack to go to. Now, those are my go-to. Next question that she asks was, how's the housing market with COVID-19? Right now, I would say it is at a pause. Nothing's really going up. Nothing's really going down. It is just at a pause. But if things continue the way they are now, with people losing their jobs, people not having a job, people not having sources of income, businesses closing down, I think we're gonna start to see the prices of homes start to decline a little bit. So that is just my opinion, and that I don't have a crystal ball, so I don't know exactly what's gonna happen. But that's my prediction, and that's kind of what I've been hearing in my industry. Her next question is, advice for those who are less motivated. I would say really introspect, take part of like a day to sit down on your own, put on some meditating music, and really start to introspect and figure out what your why is in life, what motivates you, what motivates you, ask me. Anyways, figure out what is the reason you get out of bed. A lot of people, their kids are the reason why they continue to push forward. So really dig deep and look in within yourself and figure out what your why is. What is that true why that's gonna get your ass out of bed and get you going for the day? And I would also say try to incorporate exercising, especially in the morning. That really gets the body going and the mind flowing. So. But definitely take some time to sit on your own, put some music on, meditation music, and really introspect and figure out what your why is. All right, next question from Emily is, thoughts on speech therapy for my lisp? Some people say I have lisp, some people say I don't. I think I do, and I don't know if I should get a therapist. I think I'm just too old for this now. I think people should just appreciate the way I talk, I guess. And I don't know, maybe I should look into them, because I do tend to fumble over my words or mumble a lot when I get excited. I feel like my brain sometimes thinks a lot quicker and than my actual mouth does. So maybe I should look into that. What do you guys think? All right, so another question from Emily is favorite cuisine. See what I mean? Anyways, she asked me, what is my favorite cuisine? I would say Italian food. I love Italian food or pasta. And if I had to choose something specific within the pasta realm, I would say lasagna. That lasagna is just like, Last two questions from Emily, the second to last, is what is your most proud moment, biggest accomplishment? Most proud moment slash biggest accomplishment was when I graduated from Cal State Long Beach. I think just seeing the tears of joy and the excitement that came out of my parents when I told them I was going to be graduating, when they saw me walking down the ceremony path, I just seeing that, I think that to me, I can just say it's my most proudest and my greatest achievement thus far. And I think it's more for my parents than for me, but hey. Last question from Emily, guilty pleasure. There's a couple guilty pleasures that I have. One is video games. This is why I don't have a gaming console in where I live, because if I turn on that video game console, especially FIFA or Call of Duty, I just get sucked into it and I'd rather not. So that's one guilty pleasure. And two, sweets. Oh man, sweets, brownies, ice cream, Mexican candy. Oh, those are just my guilty pleasures. All right, moving on. This next question comes, he has two questions. My good friend Mike, AKA Swanky. His first question, this is a good question. So what exactly is FHA? Can they help me buy a house? So good question, Mike. And just to give you a heads up, I'm actually gonna be doing a video talking more about home buying programs, especially for first time home buyers or regular people like you and I. There are plenty of programs out there that can help us. And so I'm not gonna go too much into detail about this, Mike, because I'm gonna be making a full video on it and I'll be releasing it next week. So, but just to give quick details about the FHA. FHA stands for Federal Housing Administration, and they provide a loan to people who make less money or whose credit score isn't that high. Basic requirements, you have to have at least a minimum of 500 credit score. If you have a credit score between 500 and 579, you have to put at least 10% down for a home. If you have a 580 or up, you can put as low as 3.5% down on a home. And those are just some quick details on it, and they do help people get into homes. And there are more details on that, so I'll get more into that on the next video. But Mike's next question is, do you have some programs that help first-time home buyers? Again, I'm gonna be talking about this a little more in my next video, but just some quick ones. Obviously the FHA loan, there's a VA loan that helps people in the military. There is one called the Good Neighbor Next Door program that's good for teachers and professors. There's one called the Home Possible program. There's one called the Home Ready program. There's one called the Unison program. You can Google these and figure out a little more about what they are and what the guidelines are. Essentially, they all have different guidelines that you have to meet, but they are all great for first-time home buyers or people with lower income or just people who just want to get in the home. So I'll be talking more about that in my next video. All right, this next one comes from Moreno, and he asks, do you have any regrets or anything you might have done differently? Do I have any regrets? Honestly, I don't have any regrets. I'm grateful for my life and the life I've lived. Yes, there are things I would have done differently. For example, like I mentioned earlier, when I was 18, going through 20, between 18 and 22, I would have partied less and focused more time on something that would actually provide value, not just fun all the time. So that's something I would have done differently. But other than that, I don't have any regrets. I'm pretty happy. Next question comes from a gentleman. His Instagram handle is CTILLJ, and he asks, do you invest in real estate yourself? At the moment, I don't. I'm looking into getting my first investment property by the summer, so that's in the work. But I have worked with plenty of investors, so I kind of know the way around investing in real estate. Next question comes from that dude Hector underscore. And he asks, what motivates you to go the extra mile in your job, like if you don't sell a home? I would say my quick answer is fear. Fear actually motivates me, and people might be wondering, what the hell? How does fear motivate you? So I have this fear that if I don't amount to nothing, I'm just gonna waste my life. So my biggest fear is I don't wanna waste my life. So that actually drives me and motivates me. One day I wanna have a family, I wanna have kids running around. And my fear is that if I don't work hard now, I'm not gonna be able to provide the life that I want for my future family. So I work hard today to try and create the life that I want for my future and for my future family. And my biggest fear is that I won't be able to do that if I sit on my ass and do nothing. So fear is a huge motivation factor for me, and that's how I leverage fear. And I recommend you try doing that too. Don't be afraid of fear. Fear is good. Without fear, we are not humans. The next question comes from Carlo. Carlo, how you doing, buddy? Have you gotten your CPA certification? Let me know. He asks, first place you want to go after the quarantine is over? Ah, man. Honestly, to be honest, the first place I want to go is to be able to hang out with my friends and my family at a restaurant or at their house during game night. I want to be able to do that again. So that is my answer to you, Carlo. I just want the normal life back. I want to be able to just go out without a fear of, you know, catching some sort of crazy virus. And that's kind of what I want and what I want to do and where I want to go when this quarantine is over. All right, coming down to the last final two questions, and this second to last question is from my good friend Bobby Alvarez, and he asks, yo Sergio, do you see the housing market prices dropping anytime soon? So as I said before, I do see the prices of homes coming down. When that'll be, I have no idea. I don't have a crystal ball, but I do see them coming down. As I mentioned, if things continue the way that they are now, with people being laid off, people filing for unemployment and all that good stuff, or all that bad stuff, I do see prices of homes coming down. How far they're gonna come down, I am not sure. But one thing I do know is that the prices of homes are not gonna drop as bad as they did when it was 08, 09. And the reason for that is just the market right now, in the real estate market, it's just a lot more structured. It's a lot stronger than it was back when the 08, 09 recession happened. There are many more factors to it. But yes, in short, I do see the prices of homes coming down soon, but just not as bad as it was in 08 or 09. So that's that. All right, so last and final question comes from a gentleman named Lucas, and he asks, how are you and your family getting through this pandemic? What are the things you are doing as a family that you probably wouldn't be doing if there was no coronavirus pandemic? And to be honest, nothing really, there's not much we can do at this time. I live with my girlfriend and two roommates, and two of my roommates, or actually one of my roommates, she goes to work, my girlfriend goes to work at a hospital, and me and my other roommate, we kind of just take it day by day. I like to try to stay as productive as possible. I like to read my books. I'm constantly reaching out to my clients and kind of touching base with them and see how they're doing and reaching out to friends. That's kind of my day to day. And by the time my girlfriend gets home, it's around 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock. I like to just unwind and just watch Netflix with her and spend some quality time. And I think that's really just it. It's just spending more quality time, because before this whole coronavirus pandemic, I'm not sure how many of you guys this would happen to, but to me, you'd get caught in the day to day and you'd forget that you'd sometimes need to just step back from work and from business and just relax and spend time with your significant other or your family or your loved ones, whoever that might be. So yeah, hopefully that answers your question. And that concludes all the questions and answers. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope some of my answers provided some sort of value or entertainment. If it did, please give me a like. Leave me a comment. Let me know what you guys think. If you guys have any more questions, don't hesitate to reach out. Send me a DM. I have nothing else to do during these times, so go ahead and reach out and let's chit-chat a little more. But anyways, guys, if you guys made it this far, I'm going to give you guys a promo code to buy my delicious coffee. I'm just totally kidding. Anyways, guys, I love you guys. I'll see you on the next one.